it's really good to have you here. Can you tell me a bit more about what you do and why you're at Campus Party?
So I'm Professor Ben Shedd. I teach at the School of Art, Design, and Media at Nanyang Technological University, and I run the filmmaking area. And as well, I'm also a professional documentary filmmaker. And so I work in the big immersive space. I've done 3 Omnimax giant films. So this is my university hat that I use all the time. And when I'm doing films, I can wear this hat. But when I have to do these big immersive screens, I have to wear it this way because you have to have it big enough to be able to see. It's one of those things that I've been trying to figure out how to do. And here at the Campus Party, we have a 7-meter dome with a bunch of student work. So it's big, huge imagery. And that's part of what I teach that class, and I also teach filmmaking.
That's very interesting. So can you tell me about some difficulties that you have faced and how you managed to overcome your difficulty?
I've grown up making movies, and they're always inside of a frame. And while teaching and thinking about that frame and cutting, about halfway through my professional life, I had the opportunity to suddenly do Omnimax, which is like the big dome at the Singapore Science Center. And there's a bunch of smaller domes. It's very much like VR these days, because the difference is that when you're making movies, your head has to stay in one spot while you're watching them. And in VR, you can start looking around and moving. And so I suddenly had to figure out how to get rid of the frame that I've used all my life. And I've done a bunch of research, which I call exploding the frame. So it reminds me all the time that I have to do about the opposite all the time of what I've thought about before. And one of the things that in my filming is that we often film sunrise and sunset. And what I've really recognized is that the sun isn't moving. It's the earth that's rotating. It's really dawn and dusk. I like to think of it as earth rotation. And because I've had to wait for the light a lot, and you don't wait for the sun to move in the sky, you have to do this opposite thinking. And I've discovered that the opposite thinking also applies in having a frame and not having a frame.
What do you think young people can do to involve themselves more in film?
How to get involved in film? A couple of ways, and one is to get a job and work as a, you know, the word is gopher. You go for this and you go for that. It's a production assistant job, even though you probably have a lot more talent than that and are worth more. But it lets you go and see how the job is done. Because the thing about filmmaking in particular is it's a large crew of people, and everybody has different kinds of specialty jobs that all combine together. And I did a gopher job for a while, just after I left film school. But then I've also been able to do, I've been a director and a producer of a lot of science documentaries. And I've learned to be able to work with crews. And it was one of the things that was very helpful was to be able to see what the work was like before it was actually on my shoulders and my responsibility.
So what is something about film that you absolutely love, or like it keeps inspiring you to like keep going?
So my whole life I've been making films. It was actually an accidental gift from my father, who was a sign painter, and he made my brother and I costumes that made us look like Prince Valiant and King Arthur, and it was made out of cardboard. And all the kids in the neighborhood wanted one, and he made 12 sets. There were 7 of us. I was 12 of us, and I was 7 years old. The next door neighbor owned a camera store, and we made a movie. It's called Knights of the Square Table because we didn't have a round table, and it became the first of 7 films we made every summer while I was growing up. And I was in all kinds of dramas. I did costumes. I played a cowboy. I played an airplane pilot. And it was, and growing up, I just learned to do wide shot, close up, cut, look at the camera, don't look at the camera. You know, it was just part of life. And so in many ways, it's my second language or my first language. And, you know, it's interesting, I find that there are things that we are just raised with that we don't even think about ourselves, that become a habit, and that they become things we do as adults. So now I've produced and directed 33 professional films, including 3 IMAX films.
So any final tips or advice that you will give to aspiring filmmakers?
So as the professor at the School of Art, Design, and Media, we teach filmmaking, and we get a number of the students that come from the Polys as well, and LaSalle has a wonderful program. And it's really interesting to see the experience that the students get in the classroom, so you get much more professionally grounded, but ready along the way. And so I do think it's really useful to study. There's also wonderful resources online to be able to learn some of the techniques along the way. And I'm finding that many people who are two generations younger than me now come really well skilled in a lot of the digital skills, and then find out ways to apply them and ways to think of the value that you can have, so that you deliver high quality. And one of the key things I learned along the way is you really have to be on time. You have to be on schedule, because there's usually 30 or 40 people, and anybody delayed causes a big schedule challenge, and it costs money. And one of the phrases that sticks in my mind a lot is that I heard was, you know, if you're early, you're on time. If you're on time, you're late. And if you're late, you're fired. And you got to be remembering that all the time. So it's just one of those processes about understanding that the clock is ticking once you become a professional. And that, you know, that was one of the biggest changes I had to do when I became professional, to be really concerned about the time for people, make sure people are healthy and that sort of thing. Get enough sleep at night. It's easy to work all night long. You don't want to do that all the time. So my suggestions for getting into film are twofold. One is to find ways to study it, whether you do it in high school, university, at the undergraduate level, at the graduate level. I have 2 degrees in filmmaking, so I studied it a lot. But the other is that there's to find the different kind of resources online and do a lot of learning from all the tutorials that are available.